Hello, friends. Last time we talked about the basics of the clamper and classify the clamper. We can classify the clamper like positive, negative. One more way to classify the clamper, that is the biased clamper and unbiased clamper. Now, as capacitor plays an important role, battery has its own significance to shift our signal in upper direction or down direction other than the zero level. If you are asked to have the clamper clamp at 2, clamp at 3, clamp at minus 3, in that case we must have a DC energy source as a part of your clamper circuit. So now, in this next session, I will talk about what is the difference between the clamp by and clamp at. If we want to specify the clamper in terms of the clamp at, then there is no need to have the idea about the input. But if you are asked to comment like clamp by, in that case you must have the idea about the circuit as well as you must have the idea about the input as well. One more thing that I would like to discuss in that next session, that is the practical clamper. So in that case, we will take a case of the internal resistance of source, forward bias resistance of diode, reverse bias resistance of a diode. We will take care of our even load resistance. In that case, my output will not be shifted suddenly. It will take some time, it will take some cycles to settle down. But finally, outcomes of a practical clamper will be the same as an outcome of ideal clamper. So in that case, I will explain that RC network, how capacitor charge, how capacitor discharge, and then we will analyze that practical clamper for few more cycles. And if time permits, I will go with the capacitance offered by the diode. So that's all about the agenda of the next session. Thank you.